Welcome back to This Guy's Garage. Today, we're refurbishing a wood stove. It's a seasoned wood stove. It has a couple of cracks in it. So what we're going to do, fill in the end of the crack, drill in them out. I'm going to V this out, weld it up, and I'll show you the before and after. We're going to take this thing into the 20th century, or the 21st century. I don't know what century it is. Here's the before. We're working on the after, and all this is coming up.
This Guy's Garage. Like and subscribe.
All right. Now that we got these cracks lined up, I'm going to V them out, weld them up, and we're going to make this seasoned wood stove look like that. $2,000. That's probably the cost of an entry-level stove. So we're going to take the Death Wheel 2000 here with no safety guard. We're going to V out these notches, weld them back up, and this thing will be as good as new. All right, let's fire up the welder. Alright, let's buff it off. So now I'm going to buff off these welds, smooth them out. We'll be painting before you know it. Next on the to-do list, some sanding. I'm starting out with 80, gonna knock these grind marks back, then I'll work my way up to 400. So as far as painting options go, there's not a whole lot on the areas that have heat. Yesterday I painted the surround that goes around this. I painted a base coat, clear coat. On the stove itself, I don't have many options, so I'm using a high heat paint. It's from Home Hardware, Beauty Tone, but any high heat paint will do. If you want a shiny paint, that's personal choice. I went with a flat black. So right now I'm just going to take some degreaser, wash it off. I'll tack it off and put some paint on it. No need to get super fussy with it because it's a spray bomb. But I'm getting pretty fussy. Always use a tack cloth to remove any dust or debris. Just let it roll across. So next thing we've got to do is take care of this brass door. The 90s called and they want the brass door back. So in order to paint this, I've got to at least scuff up this brass coating, if not remove it altogether. So I'm going to test it with the sander first. If not, I'm going to have to move on to the disc grinder. Wait a tick. Look at that. Wonder if I can get that to come up to a shine. Next thing we're going to do, scratch up the trim. For this, I'm using some trim and bumper paint, satin black. We'll show up against, nice against the shiny black. So if this video helped you out some, you can help us right back by hitting that subscribe button. It'll be right there. You can watch another video right around here somewhere. And until next time, folks, this guy is...